where we were. That's where we were. So these are the episodes, the phases of the 19th century Eastern Question. Of course, there will be other events, small events, minor events, which were taking place, but you will find that these events do not attract the great powers. The moment the great powers were not attracted into the Ottoman Empire, so a phase was not constituted. But where the great powers intervened into the Ottoman Empire, at a hostile stance, or at peaceful, with a peaceful agenda, then it constituted the 19th century Eastern Question. So those were the events. I've told you that with these revolts, the Second Serbian Revolt, we also have the 1812 Russian occupation of Bessarabia and the signing of the Truth of Bucharest, and then we have the Second Serbian Revolt. These ones, they do not constitute the 19th century Eastern Question. Why? Because they did not involve the great powers to fight among themselves. So, those areas which involved the great powers to fight among themselves who actually rotated on the Greek War of Independence, Syrian Question, Crimean War, and the Balkan Crisis of 1875 to 1878. So, that is a summary of the 19th century Eastern Question. Summary of the 19th century Eastern Question. So the 19th century Eastern Question involved all of those issues. Involved all of those issues that originated within Turkey and attracted the attention of the great powers. So there are issues between Turkey and the great powers. That's what we term as the 19th century Eastern Question. Now, subtopic. What is the subtopic? Reasons for the decline of the Ottoman Empire when in the 19th century. Reasons for the decline of the Ottoman Empire in the 19th century. Many times we say the question of this nature because we want you to relate. We want you to apply knowledge. If the Ottoman Empire was big to the extent of this nature and it collapsed, where can it apply to us in the modern times? Not necessarily state formations or state existences. No. Even in the families where we are, you have been hearing particular families, very famous, and after some years, some families are not there. They are completely off. Huge tribes existing and occupying areas, existing for some years, and then all of a sudden, after some years, it is gone. We had empires here. We had the Bunyoro Empire. Bunyoro Empire was extending as far as Midiana here, as far as almost Bombo here. Where is it? So forth. Extinct of states, extinct of empires, usually takes place. So, what were the reasons that were responsible for the decline of the Ottoman Empire? Someone among you may even ask a question. Can a question be said from that subtopic? Yes. Account for the decline, for the gradual disintegration of the Ottoman Empire in the 19th century. So a question can be of that nature. This is a question that account for the gradual disintegration
gradual disintegration of the Ottoman Empire. Ottoman Empire when in the 19th century. Question of that nature.
Or at times at a level, some questions which are indirect may be said when actually a question is demanding for the same facts. A question like, for example, account for the emergence of the 19th century Eastern question.
Question can be like that. That account for the emergence. Account for the emergence of the 19th century. Or the 19th century Eastern question. Account for the emergence of the 19th century Eastern question.
Questions so can be said from this subtopic. So, reasons for the decline of the Ottoman Empire in the 19th century. Why was this empire declining? Why was this empire disintegrating? Why?
Why?
The empire was disintegrating, the empire was declining because of various reasons. Various reasons. Which reasons were here? Which reasons? I may be forced to erase, to remove these ones, especially the questions, because the questions, you can have them somewhere, but the subtopic will remain. So, these factors were, one, were external factors. Factors coming as a result of events, as a result of circumstances beyond the Ottoman Empire, far away from the Ottoman Empire. External factors. As we are going to be seeing them, external factors. Not necessarily within the Ottoman Empire, but factors beyond the Ottoman Empire. They were external factors. Two, they were internal factors. Factors within Turkey. Factors within the administration of the Ottoman Empire, Constantinople. Factors within the limits of the boundaries of the empire. These internal factors, students, were social. The factors were economic. The factors were political. Internally. So we are saying that the factors which led to the gradual disintegration of the Ottoman Empire in the 19th century were external factors, were internal factors. And internally, they were social, they were economic, they were political. Now, we are moving to categorization. For example, if we begin with external factors. What were the reasons that led to the disintegration of the Ottoman Empire? If you have tribes where you come from that collapsed completely, they disappeared, they were conquered, you have empires, you have states, you had kingdoms which existed where you come from, but they are no more. What happened? External factors. Very soon we are going to see states collapsing completely, disintegrating. We almost experienced one in Africa here, Somalia. Somalia was going completely. almost being extinct. What were the reasons for the collapse of the Ottoman Empire? External factors. Now, external factors, we have factors like the impact of, so we have the impact of the 1789 French Revolution. 1789 French Revolution. External factors, we have factors like the impact, we have the impact of the American War of Independence. We have factors like the intervention, intervention of the great powers at various times. We have factors like the impact, of the English, social political setup. External factors impacting upon Turkey, influencing the Turkish people, and the Turkish people automatically, the subjects revolting against the masters, and so constituting an internal crisis, and therefore an empire disintegrating. 1789. Many of you learners, many of you students, you know the 1789 French Revolution, because that was the first topic in Senior 5. Must be knowing it. Senior 5. Those who don't study A level, you could have come across it, the 1789 French Revolution. When it occurred, this French Revolution of 1789 produced doctrines. It produced doctrines, ideas which became the basis of fair governance. They became the basis of fair governance. What were those basics of fair governance? Produce desire for freedom. Produce desire for equality. Produce desire for democracy. And also produce the desire for fraternity. Fraternity. That's what we call brotherhood. All of these formally were lacking in the administration of the Ottoman Empire. They were lacking in the administration of the Ottoman Empire. These ideas, which were produced by the 1789 French Revolution, were spread into areas governed by the Turks. For example, the Balkan areas here. And therefore, the enslaved and the ruled Balkan people, the Slav race, were affected. They were impacted upon. And so they desired for fraternity, brotherhood. They desired for freedom. They desired for equality. They desired for democracy. That's why eventually various rebellions began by these people against the rule of the sultans at Constantinople. And that constituted the slow and gradual decline of the empire. So the impact of the 1789 French Revolution was very, very, very important.